The title is Candy. It was inspired by, well, a few things, but like Walk on the Wild Side. The character Candy came out from the island in the back room. She was everybody's darling, but she never lost her head, even while she was giving head. Mm-hmm. Hey, babe, take a walk on the wild side. Mm-hmm. So that was my favorite song when I was like 12. I was a huge, I am still a huge Lou Reed fan. Always have been, always will be. So, so there's that. It was also, it's also sort of based loosely on just, you know, experiences that I had in the 2 years that I was, you know, sort of going through this divorce. And, you know, my father's film, A Dangerous Method, and like this actor that I met and this poet that I met who's in the film, and the relationship I had with him. And he's Mark DiSaverio. He's a poet. And he's in the film reciting his poem. Also, it's sort of based on some gender. I was having some sort of gender identity crisis also at the time. So so that sort of comes out in the film. Also, some mental health issues. You know, Mark is bipolar, and two of the actors are transgendered. And I was having sort of not feeling like becoming transgendered, but I was just having some sort of, I don't know, odd gender experiences, mm-hmm. With my, within myself, mm-hmm. that were, that I just wanted to explore. So that's, you know, and then just sort of, yeah, I mean, it's short, it's 8.5 minutes, so.
Right, right, okay.
And yeah. It's also about suicide and art, like, and, yeah.
So it's a narrative then, or is it sort of
It's not really narrative. Yeah. It's not really experimental. I would just, you know what I would define it as? Abstract. Mm-hmm. It's abstract.
Okay.
Yeah.
And is it
There's
all...
some narrative, there's some experimental stuff, but I would say, if I were to describe it, like how it ends anyway, on the note it ends on, it's abstract. Like it would be most similar to an abstract painting. Oh, cool. Like more color, emotion, and some form. You know, but not that much form.
Right.
Yeah, like it's not, it's more like an abstract painting for sure.
And is it done in 35 or 16 or?
That's a good question. 18? Like what, you know, film doesn't exist anymore. So
yeah.
It's red epic.
Also,
what does that mean?
HD. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. It's sad. I mean, I had to mourn that because when I was in film 15 years ago, it was film.
Right.
So when I came back, it was very sad to me. I acted in my film. And it was my first time acting. I mean, I'd been an extra a bunch of times in my dad's films when I was, you know, younger and stuff like that. But it was my first time acting. And oh my God, do I have respect for actors now, like beyond what I ever did? It's really difficult to repeat the same thing again. I mean, I don't know how they do it. Funding it yourself is like, if you can, is like absolutely it's like the artist's wet dream for sure. And you know what? Funding it myself is the best feeling ever. Like, it's so great because it's like you're not indebted to anyone else and you're just, it's your own thing. And it's like, it's really a great feeling. And you don't have to fill out any forms for grants. Like, I'm like any artist, like, who the it's like the worst system. It's like artists who are the most, like, you know, it's like to have to fill out a form and like, write pages on the intellectual, like, I'm a naive artist, right? I can't go outside. I learn about my art while I'm doing it and afterwards. I can't beforehand write some 3-page thing about what my art's about, the philosophy of my art. Blah, like, it makes me physically ill. I've been sucked in by fear, which is insurance. I've been sucked in by anger, which is lawyers. And what was the other one? Banks. And I've been sucked in by wanting to make money.